Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel Swami Vijay, and this is Swami Vijay speaking to all. In this video I am going to show you how to conduct online examination in a collaborative way. What does this collaboration means? You can add collaborators into your Google form and you can conduct examination. If I want to explain more detail, say for example there are two teachers who are handling subject English for two different sections of class 12. And when the examination time comes, these two teachers have to set a common question paper for these two section students. Are in a private school or in a very big school, there may be five or six sections for each and every class. So there may be four or five teachers who are taking online classes, but when it comes to setting a question paper, your principal might have told you to set a common question paper for all the sections of the class 12 or class 11 or any other class. So in that situation, all four teachers can set a common question paper. They can share the question paper from their login and they can even evaluate the answers or responses sent by the students into one common folder. So this would be more convenient to conduct online examinations in a collaborative way. Like four or five teachers, they can set a question paper and they can conduct the online examination, and as well as they can even evaluate the online question paper responses. So I'm going to show you that how to do without any delay. But before I start the video, if you are not yet subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel and press the notification bell so that you can receive latest updates and information the moment I upload videos on YouTube. And like, share and comment on this video. First, you have to log in into your Google Form or Google Drive, whichever is convenient way. You can log in into your Google Form either from Google Classroom or directly from your Google Drive. So let me first select Google Drive here. Click the Google Drive and here right side you can see New Google Forms select, and once you click the New Google Form, here you will get one untitled form. But I have already set a question paper, so I am not going to set another question paper. I am going to show you that question paper which I have already set and how to share that question paper to all other teachers. If you are the setter of the question paper, if you set the question paper, how to share the question paper with your colleagues. So let me show you here. I have set one question paper, monthly test August for class 12. So let me click that. So this is a question paper I have already set and I have received the responses also. Now let me show you first how to share this question paper with your colleagues. You have set the question paper and now you are going to share this question paper with your colleagues so that your colleagues can share the question paper in their respective sections at the time of online examination. First you have to add your colleague as a collaborator. Now let me show you how to do that. Here you can see on the right side of your screen, more options are three dots. Click that three dots and here you can see add collaborators. To add your colleague as a collaborator, you have to select this add collaborators. So click add collaborators. So once you select this add collaborators, it will take you into this and you'll get this pop-up on your screen. Add editors, add people and groups. So you can add your colleagues into this Google form as editors, or even sometimes you can add them as even viewers. So here you can see I am the question paper setter and I am the owner, and nobody can access to this question paper without sharing this question paper link. But first let me show you how to add your colleague as a collaborator. Now here there are so many teachers are there, so many people are there. I am going to add one person as this editor to this question paper which I have already set. So let me select that one, and here you can see notify people. You can send the message, you can write the message to that teacher. You can write like this: dear sir, you are, or sir or madam according to your need, you are now editor to this question paper. And then you have to select this send. But before that, let me show you one more information. Here you can make that teacher as an editor, or even you can set them as a viewer. But it is better to select editor option so that they can check the answers or responses received by sent by the students into the Google Drive. So here you can see editors will be able to view and delete from form responses. So we have to select sent. So once you select send, that particular teacher has added into a collaborator. So that person can even check the question paper and can send the question paper from his login. Now let me show you how the teacher whom you have added as a collaborator receives the mail in his Gmail account. So let me go to the another teacher's login. So once you click Gmail here, the teacher has received already a mail. Here you can see, let me zoom here. So here you can see that the information he got through Gmail account. So here you can see yvkswami@gmail.com has invited you to edit the following form, monthly test August 2020 English. Here the message, dear sir, you are now editor to this question paper. So select open in forms. That means your colleague, your friend can also open the form from his or her login. So let me select open in forms. So once the teacher selected open in forms, he or she can see your question paper in their login. So let me change this login also here so that there will be no confusion. So here you can see another login, learn about quizzes in Google Forms. If your colleague doesn't know how to set the question paper and how to send the responses, they can take it too. But now let me click no thanks. So here you can see the another teacher's login, and this is another teacher's email account. So here the another teacher whom you have shared the question paper can see all the information which you have set in the question paper from question number 1 to question number last question also. So there is, like, as a owner you have only one control, that you can add people and you can remove people. So editor has almost a 99% access and options available as a editor. Now the editor, what he or she can do is, the editor can send this question paper form directly. The editor can send this question paper to the students without any problem. That means if you set the question paper, it doesn't mean that you only have to send the question paper link to all the students at the time of online examination. Your colleague can also select the question paper link and send the question paper link through WhatsApp or through email. So here you can see your colleague can send the question paper to his or her sections without disturbing you, or through email, or he or she can send, even copying the information link, shorten your link and then copy the link, and that your colleague can paste that link through WhatsApp also. That means if you give access to your colleagues, your colleague can conduct online examination without disturbing you. So in this way you can add 3 or 4, even n number of teachers who are teaching the same subject, and all the teachers in a collaborative way they can conduct the online examination. So this is about conducting online examination in collaboration. Now what happens once students submit responses? Here you can see the students have submitted 173 students have submitted 173 responses. Now here it is in my teacher's login, but let me log in to my account and let me see what is the difference the teacher whom I have shared can see. So this is my login. So let me go back to my login. I can go back here only. So here you can see it is my login and it is another teacher's login. So both have same access, same options available on screen. Either I can change the responses, I can read the responses, or even the person whom I have added as a collaborator, that person can also access to all the information. Now the second part is how to evaluate answers or responses submitted by the students as a editor. The person whom you have shared the question paper may express his or her doubt that how can I evaluate answers if it is sent to your Google Drive. It is not like that. All the responses are stored in one single Google Drive if you have set a long answer question or a file upload option. Remaining all, automatically they can evaluate. So let me show you how to evaluate in your colleague's login. So this is the response tab. Same options are available for your colleague also. Whatever options are available in your login, your colleague can download responses in CSV file, and your colleague can see the summary of the responses. Your colleague or your friend can see the questions also, and individual students submission also. Exactly whatever access or whatever options available to you as a owner, your colleague also has the same options available in his or her login. Now the most important thing is file upload questions. You have set the question paper and you have shared the link with your colleague or colleagues, and students have submitted responses, and all these responses are recorded in one single drive. Now you have to know which drive is that. See here, the question paper set by me, and I have given access to my teacher, my colleague. So now here the student has submitted the response. Let me show you. 173 students have submitted the response. And when you come to his login or teacher's, the colleague's login, the colleague can see here the response submitted by the student. And once he select that response, that will take him or her to the response written or submitted by the student or file upload question. Now here one small trouble is there. If you have given access to the question paper only to your colleague may not get access to the answers submitted by the students in file upload option. The reason is all those answers or responses, file upload answers, are recorded in your Google Drive. You have to give even access to your Google Drive to your colleagues, then only they can get access to the Google Drive responses stored. For that, let me show you how to do that. Now you have understood about how to set a question paper, how to collaborate with your colleagues to share the question paper to their students without any kind of problem. They can evaluate all other questions other than file upload questions or long answer questions. To share the long answer questions, to check the long answer questions by your colleagues, you have to share your Google Drive where all the responses are stored. Now this is the monthly test August, so all the responses are stored in this folder. You can see monthly test August 2020 English 12 ABC sections file responses. So this folder is stored in your Google Drive, not in your colleague's Google Drive. So you have to give access to this folder to your colleagues also, then only they can check the responses. So let me show you how to do that. So select this one, and here you can see shared, grid view and view details. Now let me give you the access to this Google Drive to colleagues also. If you don't give access to your colleagues, then your colleagues cannot check. So as I have added one teacher to share the question paper, let me give access to that particular teacher even my Google Drive. So I have added this one, and message is, dear sir or ma'am, please evaluate the answers in Google Drive. You can write the message so that they will not get any kind of confusion, and then you have to send. But before that, you have to select whether the teacher wants, your colleague wants to just viewer or editor. It is better always to give access to your colleague as an editor. So select editor and click send. So once you shared your Google Drive with your colleague can access to the responses submitted by their students into your Google Drive. Now let me show you what your colleague has to do. Now again, let me log into another teacher's email account. So here you can see again one more mail. That means the moment you share the Google Drive, your colleague will get an email notification. Monthly test August 2020 English, dear sir, please evaluate the answers in Google Drive. Now your colleague has to open this link. Select open here. Now here you can see your colleague got access to your Google Drive. So your colleague can select that particular student who is from his section or her section, and they can evaluate. Let me show you how they can directly click the link under responses tab, and then how they can get access to the Google Drive, yours Google Drive. So here is the monthly test submitted responses. Now yours colleague wants to check another response. See here, another response is here. So let me select any student, Niharika or some other student. Let me select. Now your colleague wants to check the response submitted, I mean file upload response submitted by this particular student, because this student belongs to his or her section. Now here is the option, file upload answer submitted by his student. So he will click this and he will get into your Google Drive directly without disturbing you. So in this method, you can share your Google Drive and your question paper set in Google form so that your colleagues can also conduct examination, evaluate the answers without having any kind of problem. So in this method, you can conduct examination and you can complete evaluation in a collaborative way. So this is about the video, how to set a question paper in collaboration and how to evaluate answers and responses sent by students in collaboration. So thanks for watching this video, and if you are not yet subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel so that you can receive latest updates and information the moment I upload videos on YouTube. And if you have any questions, please leave the questions in the comment section below so that I can respond to your questions. And always remember, stay home, stay safe, and stay strong. Thanks for watching this video. If you have come to the end of this video, I believe that you are interested to watch a few more videos related to the topic. So now you can check this out video or watch this one. Click this video, it will take you into another video.